Along with her sister ship the Tirpitz, Bismarck was one of the largest battleships ever built by any nation. Bismarck gained a notorious nickname as a destructive and devastating weapon of war, especially after the Battle of the Denmark Strait, that saw the British battlecruiser HMS Hood destroyed by Bismarck and another German ship, the Prinz Eugen. The ship itself was named after Chancellor Otto von Bismarck, and almost was the length of three football pitches put together when it was laid out. It held around 2,200 men, and its main objective was to attack British supply fleets. However, after the sinking of HMS Hood, there was a strong desire by the Royal Navy to sink Bismarck. Today we look at the battle to sink the Bismarck, and remember to support our channel, please make sure to subscribe. However, before we begin, a message from today's video sponsor, World of Warships Legends. World of Warships Legends have just celebrated their second birthday, and with new updates, the already incredibly massively multiplayer online game, where you can master the seas in history's greatest warships, has got even better. There's so much new content to get stuck into, including special research projects, and the ultimate reward, the ZF6, a well-rounded German destroyer that's up for grabs. One reason I love playing World of Warships is the intense battles that you can have against people all around the world, making use of strategy and collaboration to gain an upper hand on the seas and the battlefield. Each ship in the game is very customizable, and you can take advantage of different modifications to benefit your playstyle and enhance your performance to get ahead of the enemy. Its incredible variety also means you can take control of different and iconic warships from countries such as America, the UK, Germany, Japan and many more. It's a beautiful game with realistic sound effects and offers brilliant fast-paced gameplay, meaning you can jump straight into the action and immerse yourself in intense naval engagements. Its introduction also offers a great start for all players regardless of their experience. World of Warships Legends are offering a brilliant deal for our viewers, and if you use the code listed in the video description and you sign up, then new players will receive 7 days of premium, a Tier 2 Smith, Tier 2 Aurora, 20 Eco-Tile Camouflage and 20 Rare Boosters. World of Warships Legends is available for free on the PlayStation Store and Microsoft Store, so don't hesitate, take advantage of this great offer, and join myself and thousands of other players in the sea and on the battlefield. Bismarck was designed in the mid-1930s by the Kriegsmarine as an attempt to combat the French naval expansion, and work was completed in August 1940, following the outbreak of the Second World War. It was completed in Hamburg, weighing a colossal 50,000 tons when carrying its full load. Its length was 251 metres overall, and speed was roughly around 30 knots. On board it was armed with an array of different guns, and it also carried 4 reconnaissance planes. It was commissioned into the Kriegsmarine on the 24th of August 1940, and then 3 weeks later sea trials took place in Kiel Bay. All aspects of the ship were tested, and it was found that it was rather difficult to steer. However, it was a rather formidable fighting ship, with the gun platform performing well. On the 5th of May 1941, Hitler and Wilhelm Keitel arrived in Gottenhafen to view Bismarck, and they were shown around the ship before discussing upcoming missions. It was reported that Bismarck was ready for Operation Rheinabung, a sortie into the Atlantic alongside the heavy cruiser Prinz Eugen. The idea of this mission was to block Allied shipping to the UK and to disrupt this. At the time, Britain was dependent on the huge amount of merchant ships that were bringing essential supplies, such as food, to the island. They also brought important materials pivotal to the war effort, and it was believed the blockade could force the British into surrendering, or even negotiate an armistice with Germany. For the operation, Bismarck's crew was increased, and at around 2 a.m. on the 19th of May 1941, it left Gottenhafen for the Danish Straits. Prinz Eugen joined the mission at around 11:25 a.m, and the ships were escorted by 3 destroyer ships, with the Luftwaffe providing further air support and cover. The next day the ship's crew were told of the mission, and shortly then a group of around 12 Swedish planes saw the German fleet, and reported where it was heading. An hour after this, the fleet came across a Swedish cruiser, which shadowed them for hours. The secrecy of the operation was blown, and the British were informed, with Bletchley Park codebreakers confirming that imminently a raid in the Atlantic was to take place, and Spitfires were dispatched to search for the flotilla. In the evening of the 20th of May, Bismarck arrived in the Norwegian coast, and they knew that British aircraft was looking for them. In Norway, Bismarck did not refuel, and they then tried over the next few days to head through the Denmark Strait. As they approached, radar was activated, and they arrived at the north of Iceland at around 12 p.m. on the 23rd of May. At 19:22, the British cruiser HMS Suffolk was detected around 12,500 metres away, and permission was given to the Prinz Eugen to engage. However, it held fire before Suffolk retreated and shadowed the German ships at a safe distance. At 20:30, HMS Norfolk arrived with Suffolk, but got too close to the Germans, and the order to engage was given, with Bismarck firing five salvos. The engagement was brief and HMS Norfolk managed to escape, but at 2200 hours, Bismarck made a 180-degree turn to face the two ships, facing them head-on. HMS Suffolk's radar anticipated the move and evaded. It was on the 24th of May 1941 where the Battle of the Denmark Strait took place between the Kriegsmarine and the Royal Navy. The British battleship HMS Prince of Wales and the battlecruiser HMS Hood took on Bismarck and Prinz Eugen. HMS Hood was the largest and heaviest warship in the world when it was first commissioned, and it was the pride of the Royal Navy, solidifying the British naval dominance. The RAF was able to track down the movements of Bismarck, and then the Royal Navy's ships were given permission to search for the German ships and to try and take them out. At around 3 a.m. on the 24th of May, HMS Suffolk regained contact with Bismarck and HMS Hood, and the Prince of Wales were around 35 miles away, ahead of the Germans. At 5:35 a.m, the lookouts on board the Prince of Wales spotted the German ships, and it was clear a battle would erupt. Hood opened fire at 5:52 and sought to take out the Prinz Eugen first, with the British believing Eugen was in fact Bismarck. The Prinz of Wales struck Bismarck three times, with the first shell striking the commander's boat and inflicting damage to the seaplane catapult, the second passing through the bow from one side to another, but it did not explode, and the third struck the hull underwater and burst inside the ship, flooding the generator. The Germans held fire initially. However, a salvo from Bismarck caused chaos with one shot, sending a huge flame upright onto HMS Hood. Then there was a huge explosion that destroyed a large part of the ship. The ship broke into two, and the stern then fell away, and it was clear HMS Hood was in trouble. A shot had caused damage to one of the magazines, causing the explosion, and the wreck showed it was beyond repair. This then left the Prince of Wales alone, and it eventually retired from battle at around 6:10 a.m. On Bismarck, the crew were ecstatic and they believed it was just a matter of time before they would take out the Prince of Wales. The Prince of Wales, along with Norfolk and Suffolk, was still at sea tailing the German ships. On the 24th of May in the early evening, Bismarck was attacked by a group of Swordfish biplane torpedo bombers, and one hit was scored on Bismarck, but it only caused superficial damage. Bismarck was being shadowed by the British and did eventually lose her pursuers, and contact was lost. However, on the 26th of May, a recon aircraft spotted Bismarck and reported her position, and the ship's position was known to the British, and a decision was then made to go after her. The attack began at around 2100 hours in darkness, and Swordfish torpedo bombers found the Bismarck with their radar. One Swordfish released a torpedo and hit the German ship, hitting her port side, and it jammed Bismarck's rudder and steering gear. This meant it could only travel in a circle direction, and repair efforts were made to free the rudder, but this failed. Admiral Lurchens, in control, stated to the German command, "Ship unmanoeuvrable. We will fight to the last shell. Long live the Führer." Bismarck was now really a sitting target, and was targeted by torpedo attacks, but British ships converged on Bismarck's position. At 8:10:43 on the 27th of May 1941, the King George V spotted Bismarck at around 25,000 yards away, and HMS Rodney opened fire at 8:47, as did the King George V. Bismarck could not steer, and a storm made things very difficult. Bismarck did return fire, but a salvo from HMS Rodney damaged the main battery turrets, and Bismarck's shooting was greatly affected, which caused the British to get closer with their guns. By 9:31, all of the main battery turrets were out of action. More torpedoes were launched at Bismarck with more hits, but the Germans refused to surrender. In total, the British ships fired around 2,800 shells with around 400 hits, and there was much flooding on board the German ship. It was taking on much water, and Bismarck was in deep trouble, as were the number of crew members on board. The flooding was uncontrollable, and nothing could be done, and at around 10 a.m, First Officer Hans Erls, the most senior surviving officer, issued the order to abandon ship. he instructed preparations to be made for scuttling. HMS Dorsetshire was then ordered to close and then torpedo the Bismarck, whilst King George V and Rodney turned away. HMS Dorsetshire fired two torpedoes into the starboard side of Bismarck and one hit. It then moved to her port and fired another torpedo which hit. The ship was already in a bad state and the torpedo attacks made things worse. At the time, the last torpedo exploded against the superstructure, which was already underwater, and Bismarck began to capsize at 10:35 and had already gone underneath the water level, stern first, within 5 minutes. The Dorsetshire then tried to rescue survivors, however a U-boat alarm forced them to leave the scene, and only 111 of Bismarck's crew were rescued, leaving the majority of the 2,200 crew struggling in the rough seas of the Atlantic. The next morning, only three survivors were picked up in a raft by a German U-boat. The sinking of Bismarck was seen as an incredible British victory, however it was at the expense of HMS Hood. The work of the Fleet Air Arm, along with the ships that sunk the huge German ship, was greatly celebrated, and for the Germans, Bismarck was seen as a huge loss. The Bismarck was one of the biggest ships ever created, and the sinking of the ship along with her sister ship, the Tirpitz, later was greatly celebrated. However, within Germany, the sinking was seen as a huge loss. It did score a huge victory against HMS Hood, but this increased the Royal Navy's pursuit of the Bismarck to sink the huge ship of the Kriegsmarine. In her final battle, the Bismarck was heavily damaged and sustained damage that would sink the iconic vessel. It was predicted by experts if the Bismarck attempted to flee, then the damage caused would have been enough to sink her. Once again, thanks for watching. To support our channel, please make sure to subscribe. And once again, thank you so much for watching.